What do you want to do today?
What do you want to do today?
What do you want to do today? What do you want to do today?
Okay, we're at my studio, 5:40, and then let's have a little look. These giant doors here. On the wall here of different projects and things that I've done in New York, just so I can remember what I've done. So you've got Pulitzer Hall there in the stairwell, Brooklyn Museum, Mikado Museum, Brooklyn Boulders in Queens, Nui House. This one's fun. So this is an apartment on Mercer Street, and I've drawn kind of on the walls and everything, and now this is like a $25 million apartment. But we just sheetrocked over the walls, so maybe in 50 years' time, someone will find that in their kitchen. I worked a lot with Amphar, so we did these kind of interactive drawing events there. Line of cyclings, bicycles with Matone Cycling. IMG WME, they sponsored, I guess, Fashion Week 2 years ago, so I did a Lexus, so that was the VIP cars and stuff.
Lexus' annual Design Disruptive Art Car Experience teamed up with Made Fashion Week to highlight up-and-coming designers and artists who are perfecting their craft unconventionally.
This is fun. So I 3D designed and printed these drawing tools, these drawing blocks. So if you're someone like me that's really comfortable with drawing with one line, well, if you can draw with multiple lines of different thicknesses of lines, and that's exactly what this is here. So let's have a look. So in here you have, for example, here you can draw with 3 pens. You put 3 pens in there, but then you can also connect these together. So now you can do 6, and now you can have super lots of fun with those. This one I call the Flying Fortress. So you can put a massive pen there in the middle, and then you have these like 6 trails kind of around there. And it's kind of trippy when you draw with these because everything is in multiples. This one I call a duster. So you almost have like a duster there, like a knuckle duster. So you put 3 massive markers in there and you only get an awesome stripe. This one's cool. I just modified this to fit on a GoPro. So this, you know, goes on like any kind of extender stick. So if you need to draw high, there you go. This one's perfect. And something like this is fun. It's, you know, it's a little bit nerdy. It's 3D design, 3D printed. But then I use something like this to draw this massive drawing on the back. And from that drawing on the back, I used that to create this collection. So here we have a collection that I did with Max Mara earlier this year. And it's an edition of 1,000 sunglasses. And each pair is numbered and different. But you can tell from there that I have a little piece of paper here. So this is that drawing on the back. And then if you imagine that you lay out 1,000 pairs of sunglasses, and each pair hits a different spot on that picture, that's the area that is on the actual sunglasses themselves. So each pair is unique and each pair is different, which is super fun. Let's put those down there. Got a fishbowl. Everyone needs a good fishbowl. Actually, I dropped one of these before and it broke, so this is my second one. But this is by a company called Arudelin, and it has this like glasscape thing in the bottom, but look at that, super fun. I had goldfish before, but they all died, so I've opted for no fish in the fishbowl. Okay, this is a collaboration I used to do with my grandmother, Miss Dot Martin, and I would send her instructions. So for example, I'll say, "Dear Gran, please sew me, go home, any color, any size," and she would sew it and then send it back to me. But she'd do, you know, she's a bad employee. She used to do things like send me this back. So I asked for go home, any color, any size, but she also sent me come home. And this was fun. We did probably, you know, over 70, 80, 90 pieces. And then we showed those at the Brooklyn Museum as an installation. And this was fun actually. So when the museum came around to my apartment to see the pieces, because I didn't have a studio then, I laid all the pieces out on my bedspread, and the bedspread at that time was black and white, like these stripes. So they said, you know, why don't we display it like this in the museum? So that's how it ended up being, you know, these pieces on this black and white almost bedspread layout there. Okay, no big deal, 2 pages in the New York Times. I turned the whole bedroom into a piece of art. I drew on everything, really fine pens, ceiling, floors, walls, and all the objects in there. So this kind of makes me laugh. Okay, we've got some helmets. Actually, these were on display in the Bulgari store in New York a couple of years ago. Sweaters. I did an edition of 100 hand-drawn sweaters, and I sold them, most of them actually, apart from these ones that I kept. And the fun thing with this is you could buy it, but then it was up to you if you wore it or if you collected it. So if everyone collected it, I'll probably buy it back from you because I actually quite like these. So these are my hand-drawn sweaters. What else do we have down here? If you've ever met me on the street, you've probably been given one of these stickers. There's some RUUs there. There's some, let me get these out. There's some URUs, so there's also some QRUs. And this is what I do. If I meet people, give them a sticker. Bam. Yeah, let me show you some of these. So I was a visiting scholar at MIT Media Lab for a couple of years in a lab called Social Computing. And we made fun projects like this. So this is a printed circuit board, for example. And I made these with my friend Jonathan Bobrow. And this is a air quality sensor, so it tests for toxicity in the air. But the fun thing about this is that instead of the traces or the kind of the lines on the board being hidden, I've exposed them and made them drawings. So we have this idea where we try and hide the traces, we try and hide the technology, but how about we expose it and share it and make it a little bit more creative? So there's a whole bunch of sensors in there. I'll show you another one. This one is a parking sensor. So it can tell if, you know, something's here or not here. And then you've got the traces on there, kind of irrelevant to the function of the board itself. Okay, let's go over here. So this is a massive piece here. And it's funny, this came back from the Buffalo Museum. This came back from the Albright Knox in Buffalo. And it's a massive kind of installation and table. And the museum was probably 100 times bigger than my studio, so I thought this piece was really small, and then it came back and actually took up half of my studio. But the basis, the idea of this piece is that everything started white. You know, all these objects started white, these characters, these toys, these bottles, and the longer that they're in existence, the longer they're on the table, the longer that they're in the space, the more marks they get on them, the more lines that they get on them, the more experience that they gain, just kind of like us as people. So for example, you know, here you have these kind of like white objects, you've got these white characters, but the longer that they exist, the more lines that they gain, the more experience that they gain, the more kind of collective knowledge that they gain. And then they move around this map, they move around this space. There's a lot more kind of bottles and objects up there, and these are bottles that I've rescued from probably the street or sometimes people's living rooms or bars and stuff like that. But everything is being watched. Everyone is being watched. All the characters, all the lines, all the toys are being watched here. Probably let's have a look at it in more detail. So there's probably some stuff that you recognize on here as kids. So for example, like this guy, the telephone. This one I actually had when I was a kid, the little record player. He used to come with those little vinyl plastic, you know, records with the bumps on. You used to put that on there. What else do we have here? Oh, and it's funny, you can tell who your drinkers are because they recognize all the bottle shapes. This is probably my favorite piece. We've got a TV. You watch too much TV. Got a nice caterpillar here.
What do you want to do today?
What do you want to do today?
What do you want to do today? What do you want to do today?
There's a couple pieces that are inverted. So these two planes are silver on black. So they're kind of the wild cards of the whole table. So that's that. So this is an interactive experience that moves and changes. What else do we have here? We have a whole series of prints, screen prints, lithographs for the who are you,
for the
you are you. And these are super fun. You know, this one's titled Open Your Eyes, any color you like, and think I'm in love with you. And then we have some fun lithographs. And one thing I like about this actually is like, this is all black ink. It's not white on black, it's all black ink kind of on that paper, and that's a lithograph printed out in Long Island City by a master printmaker. There's plenty of pens everywhere, and these are super magical markers. Let's find our way. So if you come find me, I'll give you a pen. And yeah, this is probably where I was sitting earlier today, sketching in my sketchbook. Let's have a flick through here. I'm Shantell Martin, this is my studio. Thanks for coming in and having a look around. Looking forward to sharing some adventures with you.